Hello friends, in my previous video I have already discussed about the program which will check in the input vector which elements are occurring or appearing in the input vector three times, okay, exactly three times. For that, what we have followed, basically we have created two matrix or two arrays, one dimensional arrays. One will contain all the distinct elements of the input vector, and another array will contain basically the frequency of each distinct elements. Okay, that's what I am going to show you in my this video in Java, okay, from MATLAB. Okay, so see, this was our MATLAB code which I have already discussed earlier. If you want to know the detailed explanation, please go through the link given in the description. Okay, so see, first CLC, clear all, close all, no need to write in Java. Then x equal to input enter the vector we have written in MATLAB. So what we have to write in Java? First, to take the input from the user, we have to import the scanner class. So import java.util.scanner. Scanner class is imported from the util package in Java. Here we have imported one more class, that is import java.util.arrays. Why? Because like here we have applied w equal to sort of x to to directly implement sorting in Java, there is inbuilt function sort. For that you have to import these arrays also, arrays class also, so that I have imported arrays class because directly I can implement arrays dot sort for sorting. Otherwise you can implement bubble sort or any other sorting technique, there is no issue in that also. Then class freq I am defining here. Then public static void main string args, obviously we have to write. Then create the object in the scanner class, scanner obj equal to new scanner system dot in. Then int l equal to obj dot next in. This will basically create your input array. For that, first we should know what is the length of the array, right? Because it array cannot store dynamic memory in Java. If you want to work with dynamic memory, you should go with linked list, but that concept is a bit difficult than array, so that I am going with array only. So int a equal to new int l, basically here we are creating an empty array of length l. Therefore int I equal to 0, I less than l, I plus plus system dot out dot print ln, enter the element in I plus 1 position, just to show one message. If you want, you don't need to write that also. A of I equal to obj dot next int. Clear? So by this, up to this, what we have done, up to this we have just created our input vector by taking input from the user. Then see what we have done here. W equal to sort of x in MATLAB, that is sorting of input array. Similarly here, arrays dot sort a. Okay, we are sorting our input array. Okay, then see here in MATLAB what we have done. Let's see. See here, this particular part you just observed. For I equal to 1 to length of w minus 1, here basically we are creating two arrays, right? Similarly here we are doing that only, but before that here, see, u equal to uwy, p equal to pc, that is all the distinct elements we are dynamically storing in our input array u or p. But in Java you cannot do like this, as I have just told that in Java you have to first specify the memory. So for that, first I am checking how many distinct integers are there in my input array. So for that, this particular part, that is for int I equal to 0, I less than l minus 1, I plus plus, if a of I not equal to a of I plus 1, then increment the t value, t equal to t plus 1, and don't forget to initialize your t as t equal to 1, because see here, if there are, if this particular condition a of I not equal to a of I plus 1 will satisfy, suppose you just consider, let me show you, then you can understand easily. 2, 3, 2. Suppose one sorted array is there, 2, 8, 5, sorted array, right? So 2, 5, 8, 8. Okay, then how, where the condition a of I not equal to a of I plus 1 will be satisfied? Here in between 2 and 5 one time, 5 and 8 second time, and 8 and 8 a same only. So t will be 2 if you initialize t as 0. But here there are three distinct elements, so that I am defining my t variable with 1. Okay, alright. Then we are defining our U and P variable, whatever we have defined in our MATLAB, one for storing the distant integers and another for storing the what? Frequency as length of T. Okay, so int U equal to new in T, int P equal to new in T. Then int C equal to 1, like here in MATLAB we have defined C equal to 1. Then for int I equal to 0, I less than L minus 1, I plus plus, if A of I equal to A of I plus 1, then C equal to C plus 1. Just like this part, for I equal to 1 colon length of W minus 1, if W of I equal to W of I plus 1, C equal to C plus 1. Else if, similarly here, else if, here in MATLAB we have written W of I not equal to W of I plus 1, here else if A of I not equal to A of I plus 1, then what we are doing? U of R equal to A of I, P of R equal to C, R equal to R plus 1, C equal to 1. What this will do? See, here in MATLAB we are directly storing U equal to U, W, I, P equal to P, C. But in Java we cannot do like this, right? So basically what we are doing here, see, here we have defined R as 0 because in Java array index starts from 0. Then what we are doing here, U of R equal to A of I, basically we are storing that A of I, ith position element, and P of R equal to C, then we are incrementing the index position. C equal to 1 again, we are defining like here in MATLAB, we are defining C equal to 1, alright. Then here in MATLAB what we have done? U equal to U, W of length of W, that is last element of this sorted array we are storing. Similarly here, U of T minus 1 equal to A of L minus 1. Because the sorted array is stored in A itself, so the last element of the A is equal to last element of the U, where P and P of T minus 1 is equal to C. Okay, like here P is equal to PC. Then int temp equal to 0, int re equal to 0. I have defined here, if you want, you these two, no need to write, control S. Then for int I equal to 0, I less than T I plus plus, if P of I equal to 3, then we have to print U of I, not P of I, like here, for int j equal to 1 colon length of P. What is length of P? Length of P is what? See, length of P is T, right? Because see here, int P equal to new int T, okay? So the loop should go up to T minus 1, okay? So that I have written here, less than T, or you can write less than equal to T minus 1. That's all. If P of I equal to 3, system.out.print U of I, and to differentiate between two elements, I have just given one space. Okay, this is simple program which we can generate from the MATLAB algorithm itself. No need to worry, if you are unable to note down the program at some point of time, you just go through the link given in the description or in the comment section, I will post the code. Okay, now let us directly go to comment prompt and let us try to simulate our code. CD Java, then Java C FREQ dot Java, then Java FREQ. Okay, suppose first let us give the length. Suppose let me insert 5 elements. Okay, first position 1, then 2, then 1, then 2, then 1. See, only 1 is printed, that is 1 is only element which is appearing basically 3 times. Okay, let us check for some more. Suppose let us take now bigger array length as 10, then enter the first 8 9 8 9 8 9. So already 8 9 is 3 times done. Then 7 4 4 4. Okay, see, 4 8 9, in ascending order itself it is printing. Why ascending order? Because we have already sorted our array so that it will give output in ascending only. Okay, so I hope you have understood this program in Java. If you want to know the algorithm, please go through the link given in the description, because already I have explained the algorithm in detail in my previous video, so there is no meaning in explaining algorithm again and again in my different videos, right? So basically today in our this video we have learned how we can do frequency related array sorting based programs in Java. This is the base. You can work with this, play with this, solve different problems based on frequency related questions or problems in Java. Okay, it will improve your programming skill, no doubt. And obviously in NET you may get better algorithm also. You can follow that also. I have made this particular algorithm. This idea came into my mind. I have just implemented and I have just uploaded. This will work also. Whatever you will find comfortable, utilize that only. Okay, thank you for watching.